Our first guest tonight is one of the warmest and most popular figures in the history of American television. Tomorrow, this woman will step down after 13 years as co-host of the Today Show. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a good friend of ours, of all of ours. Here she is, Jane Pauley. Oh, Jane?
Thank you very much. Nice to see you. You look great.
You look terrific as always.
Can I tell you what an honor it is to appear on one of the 10 best television programs of the 80s?
Oh, well, thank you very much.
Did they know that?
I don't think so.
Do you know that?
No, I wasn't aware of that.
Time Magazine.
Is that right?
Time Magazine.
That's very nice of you to
mention. One of the 10 best.
Now, let me... And we're proving it nightly. Now,
well, you've got about 3 days
I know,
left
and then we're
here,
out of the category.
Sure. Right.
Now, let me just say, if this were me in your situation or me in my situation similar to your situation, I know, I'm nervous.
You'd look funny in this and I'd look funny in that.
Actually, I think it looked pretty nice in that.
Well,
but I don't know that the night before my last show, I would, you know, feel up to coming on a little two-bit deal like this.
Well, and I agreed to come here cheerfully, as a matter of fact, what, 2 weeks ago
yes.
or so when we... I was under the illusion that I was going to maintain a remarkable sense of cool, of being in control,
mm-hmm.
of professionalism right up and through the last moment, and I was wrong.
Mm-hmm.
I was wrong. This morning, to be perfectly honest, it hit me. It's like I've wondered all along if there wasn't a little part of me that hadn't been told yet.
Mm-hmm. All right.
She got wind of it this morning.
Yeah.
And she's not happy.
Well, it's a difficult thing to do.
It's really hard to leave
a situation you've been in and successful in for 13 years.
Even though I am really excited about what is coming mm-hmm. next.
And let's talk about that. What is coming next? Now, I know you're going to be doing primetime shows with you
There's
and your friend.
There's a primetime special that I have already started to shoot, as a matter of fact. So in a way, the future began about mm-hmm. a week ago
right.
when I started shooting a segment of a special which will be on the air in March.
And you and Tom had a little deal on last night?
Tom and I had a little deal on where we kind of summed up the 80s together in 44 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And, well, just the highlights.
Now, what is the topic of the special in March?
Changes. Imagine that. Uh-huh. I have learned firsthand how really fascinating going through a transition point in life is, and banal though it may be because every life has transitions,
mm-hmm.
but it's a universal, and people tend to, it resonates with everybody, whether you're talking about going home to start a family, or changing jobs, or even early retirement, or a variety of changes, that there was a universal here, and it was intrinsically interesting. So what we're doing is we're finding people at transition points, we're making changes with stories even more interesting than mine. Manuel would be a good choice, for instance. He's not going to make this.
Let me ask you a couple of questions about the change that you have now come through. You're leaving the Today Show, 13 years there. You must have good thoughts about it and bad thoughts about it. But
I don't have bad thoughts about it.
Either way you look at it, you must be happy you're not going to have to see Willard's fat ass every morning. am I close on that? Of course.
No, it's a joke.
I'm very fond of Willard.
Both raised in Indianapolis, so I have to be polite to you. You know, I was raised by a man who wouldn't hang up on an obscene phone caller.
Oh, is that right?
You know, it would be rude to hang up on somebody, so I have to continue to be civil to you. I adore Willard.
Yeah, I like Willard too. I think Willard is the last of a dying breed. He's one of the old, true pioneer professional broadcasters, and you could get Willard up any time, day or night, and he'd do the job for you. Boom, just
darn
like
right.
that.
Right.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
But he's still nuts. Now, you know, for a time, you couldn't pick up a newspaper, you couldn't pick up a magazine, and even still today, one of the USA Today, there's a big cover story about you. This whole thing, this important change in your life...
is going to come to an end tomorrow, maybe on Saturday there'll be a little, and then, as far as this publicity phenomenon,
yes.
I'm going to fall off the edge of of the earth and not be heard of.
Well, you're being modest, but I will grant you that people do go on with their lives. I mean, this is a very important thing. But were you surprised at the amount of attention that this attracted?
Surprise doesn't do justice. Mm-hmm. Shock is more in the right vicinity because, you know, what seems to be, the story seems to be, in story after story, and frankly, I love this, that Jane is she's a fine person. Mm-hmm. Isn't that kind of what they say?
Yeah.
It's not Jane is ought to win a Nobel Prize, mm-hmm. or Jane is the principal journalist of her generation. That's not what they're saying, both of which I would be flattered by. What they're saying is she's been a regular person.
Solid American womanhood.
Solid regular person. Yeah. Now, if that is the story...
Thank you very much. Thank you. I like to think I had a little something to do with that.
Never mind if it's true or completely off the mark. Yeah. That story would generate that kind of media mm-hmm. attention, I find incredible.
Well, that's of course all credit.
Where's the headline there?
It's all credit to you. Well, I don't know. I think people at one point perceived you as having been in danger. And because they feel so strongly about you and you've become such a large part of their life and a very important part of their day, they were worried and concerned. Now, another question about this. We heard all kind of stories that you were shoved out of the picture, that you were treated poorly, that this was all your idea. We heard every point of the compass. We heard that story. What can we take away from this episode that you think would be close to the truth?
That if I told you what really happened, I wouldn't look as smart as I look now, because it looks like I somehow engineered the most incredible professional promotion that anybody has ever enabled themselves to bump up into a primetime show.
Good for you.
And so if I told you what really happened, I wouldn't look the smartest.
No, you're
that
good.
Would make
good
me look.
For you. You're like a big hero of mine. I'm very, very happy for you. I think this is just great, and you got a lot of dough out of these weasels.
My impression is I was trying to give the money back.
I know, but see, my feeling is, my impression of this is, you got everything you wanted plus a lot more money.
Well,
so there you go.
No, it was a matter of having to console myself with not getting what I wanted, but the consolation was, you get this nifty new primetime show and you get to keep the money.
Yeah.
So I was able to accept that, total victory was not necessary.
That's not the name of the show, by the way, is it?
Total Victory?
No, the nifty new primetime show. We got to do a commercial. We'll be right back here with the lovely Jane Pollock. But you must...
Regards from the cartoon boy, by the way.
Oh, I'm sorry. That just came out last night. I was having trouble getting your husband's name out of the back of my mind.
He was watching at the time, and he thought, did that mean that he was raised in the wild by cartoonists or something?
No.
Cartoon boy.
We were talking about your appearance, and I said to Paul that I mentioned your family and your husband, and I couldn't think of the name Gary Trudeau, and I'm sorry. I called him Cartoon Boy. And I was hoping that would just slide right by, Yeah. What do you have there?
I was cleaning out my office, which, as we speak, is either boxes or empty. Pictures mm-hmm. are off the wall. It's all very sad, frankly.
It must be jarring to go in there and see this stuff.
Yes, even though I knew it was going to happen, I wasn't prepared for the impact. And I think that's one of the reasons today has kind of been a slippery day in an emotional sense.
Did you think about a tag sale or anything?
Well, I found some stuff. And I want to take this. I want to show it to you, but I'd like to keep it because you know how you find baseball cards if they're still in their original wrapper.
They're
in the 50s,
more valuable.
They're really, okay, so this are Jane Pauley Today business cards still in their original wrapper, and as of now, they're sort of collector's item.
Now these are a little older because they don't have the current logo on them, do they?
Uh huh.
So these go way back.
Okay.
So all right.
I brought you these. These are official Jane Pauley Today Show key rings.
Wow.
Perhaps, are you ever asked to give auction items to people?
Yes, all the time.
Well, this is a kind of a promotion.
This is what you give?
And my assistant tells me that once It was reported back to her that it brought $6.50 mm-hmm. at an auction.
About eight times what it's worth, I might add.
Probably. Now,
we usually just send them a check for 10 grand.
My thinking is, I want to give you a few of these because you probably could find some way to use them here on late night. Either give them as favors to,
right,
to guests or maybe raise some money for a worthy cause. I have three of them. Two of them are still in their original bag.
All right, good enough.
This, I found all kinds of stuff in the back of my closet that I forgot I had. One of the things I found in the back of my closet was... What's this? Do you remember?
I do remember, and it's with a great bit of trepidation that I hold this up. This is you and I. This is at the... I had just walked away from an honor farm. Moments before police apprehended me. And
we're both riding goats.
Yeah, this was the Indianapolis Children's Museum.
Exactly.
You were doing a segment of the Today Show there.
Yeah, this was probably 10 years ago.
Easily 10 years ago.
10 years ago, and the inscription says, "Dear Jane, honestly, should either of these people be on network television, let's go back before it's too late."
Yeah, that's kind of cute, isn't it?
That really is.
Yeah. This was all back in Indianapolis. Now, tell me about the first Today Show you were on. That's a silly question, but who was on? Who did you interview? Who
I
did
haven't
you talk
the
to?
The vaguest idea.
Yeah?
I really don't remember. Mm-hmm. In 13 years, I'm pretty sure there are entire years that I have forgotten.
Yeah.
You know how it is. You go through school. If I said third grade, how many details? And you spent a year there.
Right.
How many details? Maybe it's the eighth grade that you have forgotten.
Sure. Yeah.
It's possible that
it depends when you did your drinking.
What else?
What you're going to remember? What are the moments that you sometimes will dwell on and think, boy, I was really very lucky to have been a part of that?
There was that day, if there was a show, the biggest ego boost and perhaps my fondest, and it was so sweet, was the day we did the show aboard the aircraft carrier, the Coral Sea. Mm-hmm. The fact there were 4,000 sailors and me.
Ooh.
Yes, I was Brooke Shields for a day.
Yeah.
But that was, I treasure that.
What did Cartoon Boy have to say about that?
The Great Wall of China, to be able to say you broadcast a show from the Great Wall of China or live from the Roman Colosseum,
yep.
that kind of
yep.
thing, it, you know, and I do remember those
oh,
vividly.
Sure. Yeah, but it, you know, I think we have to be careful here to point out that while you did those things, you'll continue to do that kind of thing.
Do you think so?
Oh, absolutely.
Really?
I think that this is the beginning, and change is ever so important. And again, I can only congratulate you for having the courage to live through it and come out smelling like a rose and to you know, control your own fate in this business.
Thank you so much.
Nice to see you, Jane. Good luck to you. Jane Pauley, we have flowers. Please, where are the flowers for Ms. Pauley? We'll be right back, folks. Thank you.